Hi folks, Tony Fraser here. Last time we talked, I ran you through a very simple way of doing a specific gravity test to calculate the gold content in your specimens. This time round, I'm going to run through another specific gravity test. It's a little bit more complicated, but I think it's a lot more accurate and probably a lot more reliable. So we have a gold specimen here we're going to do the test on. To do this, for a start, you need, of course, a set of scales, some kind of suspension device with some fishing line so you can suspend your specimen off the scales freely, some kind of tub of water, your calculation sheet, of course, and of course a trusty calculator. So we'll try this piece to start with and see how it goes. So the gross weight on the scale says 110.1 grams. Right, now the main trick in doing this test is to make sure that you get the same weight as with the specimen suspended as you do with the weight on the scale. So for a start, I'm just going to remove the water and put this suspension mechanism here and zero that out so it goes to zero. Right, very good. Now I'm going to tie the gold specimen onto the fishing line here, and then we'll suspend it off the scales again. And if everything is going well, we should get the same weight as we did previously. Bring it out a bit, make sure it's not jagging on anything. Sometimes it can be tricky to get exact. That's 109.9, we had 110.1 before, so 0.2 of a gram, that's close enough. Right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to suspend the specimen in water. So I'll get in the water here, make sure you give it a bit of a jig up and down, make sure that there's nothing jagging anywhere, it's not touching the sides, anyway, just give it a bounce to make sure there's no air bubbles or attached to the specimen. And we're going to put it under there again and suspend it, and then we're going to get a different weight based on the buoyancy of the specimen, in which case now we get 72 grams. So now with our calculation sheet, we're actually going to calculate the actual specific gravity of this piece. So to do that, we need to divide the gross weight of 110.1 grams by the difference between the gross weight, 110.1 grams, subtract the wet weight, or the weight suspended in water. So what we end up with there is divided by 38.9 grams, which equals 2.89. So that's the specific gravity of the specimen. So then if we refer to our chart here, this gives you a list of specific gravities and then corresponding percentages of gold. 2.89, that's near enough on this chart to 2.9, which gives us a percentage of 11.98% gold. So then, we calculate 11.98% of our gross weight, gives us 13.2 grams of gold. So that calculation shows us that we have about 13.2 grams of gold in this. You know, for all reality, I'd call that 13 grams. As you can see, this specimen's got a little bit of ironstone in it and a few other bits and pieces, so these calculations are never going to be 100% accurate, but 13 grams, I'm actually pretty happy with that. So there you go, that's how easy it is. Thank you very much.